heart arrhythmias or abnormal heart rhythms. An arrhythmia is an irregular or abnormal heartbeat. The term arrhythmia refers to any change from the normal sequence of electrical impulses causing abnormal heart rhythms. Arrhythmias may be completely harmless or life-threatening. Some arrhythmias are brief, but if arrhythmias last longer, they may cause the heart rate to be too slow or too fast, or the heart rhythm to be erratic, so the heart pumps less effectively. When the heart doesn't pump blood effectively, the lungs, brain, and all other organs can't work properly and may shut down or be damaged. In a healthy heart, this process usually goes smoothly, resulting in a normal resting heart rate of 60 to 100 beats a minute. What is pulse? Pulse indicates your heart rate or the number of times your heart beats in 1 minute. Pulse rates vary from person to person. Your pulse is slower when you are at rest and increases when you exercise, since more oxygen-rich blood is needed by the body during exercise. Causes of arrhythmias. Certain conditions may increase your risk of developing an arrhythmia. These include coronary artery disease, heart problems, high blood pressure, changes in the heart muscle, valve disorders, thyroid problems, diabetes, electrolyte imbalance, congenital heart disease, other medical conditions, various cardiac medications, certain substances such as caffeine, nicotine, alcohol, cocaine, emotional stress, anxiety, age, and being overweight. Symptoms. Arrhythmias may not cause any signs or symptoms. A doctor can detect an irregular heartbeat during an examination by taking your pulse, listening to your heart, or by performing diagnostic tests. If symptoms occur, they may include a racing heartbeat, a slow heartbeat, palpitations, a fluttering in chest, chest discomfort, or pain, shortness of breath. Other symptoms may include anxiety, weakness or fatigue, dizziness, or feeling lightheaded, sweating, and fainting. The main types of arrhythmias are atrial fibrillation, in which upper heart chambers contract irregularly. Atrial fibrillation is associated with serious complications such as stroke. Having atrial fibrillation means your risk of stroke is 5 times higher than for someone whose heart rhythm is normal. Atrial flutter. The heartbeats in atrial flutter are more organized and more rhythmic electrical impulses than in atrial fibrillation. Atrial flutter may also lead to serious complications such as stroke. Supraventricular tachycardia. Episodes of abnormally fast heart rate at rest. Supraventricular tachycardia is a broad term that includes many forms of arrhythmia originating above the ventricles in the atria or AV node. Bradycardia. Slow heart rate or a slow heart rhythm with a rate below 60 beats per minute. Conduction disorders. Heart does not beat properly or normally. Premature contraction. Early heartbeat. Tachycardia, very fast heart rate, with a heart rate more than 100 beats per minute. Ventricular fibrillation, disorganized contraction of the lower chambers of the heart. Heart block, the heart beats more slowly than normal and can cause people to collapse. Ventricular arrhythmias, a ventricular arrhythmia begins in the heart's ventricles. Premature ventricular contractions, early extra heartbeats that originate in the ventricles, ventricular tachycardia, a rapid heartbeat that originates in the ventricles, ventricular fibrillation, an erratic disorganized impulses arising from the ventricles. Most people who experience ventricular fibrillation have an underlying heart disease or have experienced serious trauma. The serious problem is fatal if the heart is not restored to a normal rhythm within minutes. Long QT syndrome. The rapid heartbeats caused by changes in the electrical system of your heart may lead to fainting and can be life-threatening. Not all tachycardias or bradycardias mean you have heart disease. For example, during exercise, it's normal to develop a fast heartbeat as the heart speeds up to provide your tissues with more oxygen-rich blood. During sleep or times of deep relaxation, it's not unusual for the heartbeat to be slower. Diagnosing arrhythmias. After evaluating your symptoms and performing a physical examination, the cardiologist may perform a variety of diagnostic tests to help confirm the presence of an arrhythmia. The most effective way to diagnose an arrhythmia is with an electrical recording of your heart rhythm called an electrocardiogram. If the ECG doesn't find a problem, you may need further monitoring of your heart. Stress or treadmill test. If your symptoms seem to be triggered by exercise, stress test used to record arrhythmias. Electrophysiology study. A special heart catheterization that evaluates your heart's electrical system. Catheters are inserted into your heart to record the electrical activity. Echocardiogram. An ultrasound scan of the heart to determine if there is heart muscle or valve disease that may be causing an arrhythmia. Cardiac catheterization. Using a local anesthetic, a small flexible catheter is inserted into a blood vessel and guided to the heart with the help of an X-ray. A contrast dye is injected through the catheter. This test helps your doctor determine the cause of an arrhythmia. Treatment of arrhythmias. Treatment depends on the type and severity of your arrhythmia. In some cases, no treatment is necessary. Treatment options include medications, lifestyle changes, invasive therapies, electrical devices, or surgery. The treatments used for arrhythmias include medication, antiarrhythmic drugs to stop or prevent an arrhythmia or control the rate of an arrhythmia. Other medications may include heart rate control drugs and anticoagulant or antiplatelet drugs such as warfarin or aspirin, which reduce your risk of stroke or developing blood clots. Invasive therapies. Electrical cardioversion and catheter ablation are invasive therapies used to treat or eliminate irregular heart rhythms. Cardioversion is a medical procedure by which an abnormally fast heart rate or other cardiac arrhythmia is converted to a normal rhythm using electricity or drugs. Catheter ablation or radiofrequency ablation or pulmonary vein ablation is a procedure that uses radiofrequency energy to destroy small areas of heart tissue that's causing rapid and irregular heartbeats. Your doctor puts a thin, flexible tube into a blood vessel in your leg or neck. Then it's guided to your heart. When it reaches the area that's causing the arrhythmia, it sends out electrical signals that destroy those cells. The treated tissue helps get your heartbeat regular again. During surgical ablation, general anesthesia or local anesthesia with sedation may be used depending on the individual condition. Pacemaker. A small device containing its own battery that's implanted in your chest under local anesthetic. It produces electrical impulses to the heart muscle to maintain a normal heart rate. Implantable cardioverter, defibrillator or ICD is a device similar to a pacemaker that constantly monitors your heart rhythm and shocks your heart back into a normal rhythm whenever needed. ICD is used primarily to treat ventricular tachycardia and ventricular fibrillation, two life-threatening abnormal heart rhythms. Heart surgery. Surgery may be needed to correct arrhythmias that can't be controlled with medications or non-surgical treatment methods. Lifestyle changes. Arrhythmias may be treated to certain lifestyle factors. It's not always possible to prevent an arrhythmia developing, although a healthy lifestyle can lower your risk of developing a heart condition. The following tips can help limit the occurrence of arrhythmias. Eat a heart-healthy diet, quit smoking, do regular physical activity, maintain a healthy weight, limit your intake of alcohol, limit or stop using caffeine, avoid drinking energy drinks, keep blood pressure and cholesterol levels under control. Reduce stress. Use over-the-counter medications with caution. Maintain follow-up care. Complications. Certain arrhythmias may increase your risk of developing conditions such as stroke and heart failure. Stroke. Heart arrhythmias are associated with an increased risk of blood clots. If a clot breaks loose, it can travel from your heart to your brain. There, it might block blood flow, causing a stroke. Heart failure. Heart failure can result if your heart is pumping ineffectively for a prolonged period due to a bradycardia or tachycardia such as atrial fibrillation. Thank you.